Alright guys, sa mapagpalang araw sa inyong lahat, meron na naman tayong reaction video dito kay Karob Drip. Ito si BP Sara Duterte, magaling mamukpok ng ulo. Ayan, sabi ni Sara Duterte. At ito ay ang mga bumabatikos kay Sara Duterte para ibagsak. Pero nagkakamali kayo, lumalaban yan si sa Vice President Sara Duterte. At panoorin po natin ang buong detalye. At no other further ado, let's do the GAs and intro muna tayo.
Ako lang, which I do very well, admittedly, is magpukpuk talaga ng tao to drive a person to do what they are supposed to do. Sa totoo lang po, alam niyo po, in ASEAN, the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, there are only 3 education ministers that do not come from the education sector. Ako, Singapore, who is a military officer.
We've helped millions of creators improve their SEO.
Right, ayan ha, panoorin natin, subaybayan na itong si Vice President Sara Duterte.
And Malaysia, who is a politician as well. And I heard that Indonesia is a businessman, but I do not know if he has a education background. But alam ko tatlo lang kami sa ASEAN na hindi galing sa education sector. And para na akong sirang plaka paulit-ulit sa curriculum and teaching. Yung tanong ko paulit-ulit na hanggang tumaas na ang blood pressure ni Yusek Gina Gonong. And at one point, this was last week, no? And at one point, medyo kinabahan na ako kasi baka ma-stroke. Kasi she was really saying na okay na yan, in-review namin yan, inulit namin yan. Sabi ko, ang gusto ko kasi hindi Pilipino. Gusto ko kapag sinabi mong matatag curriculum, pag nag-benchmark ka at tumingin ka sa ibang bansa, pareho. Kung ano yung natututunan ng mga magagaling na mga bansa sa edukasyon, ganun din yung natututunan ng ating mga learners. Paulit-ulit yan. And I think I caused her so much emotional stress. But it is all good. You had your checkup, no? Yes. She did her. And then I felt guilty kasi alam ko ako yung isa ako sa nag-cause ng stress sa kanya. Because I do not come from the education sector. I do not have an education background. So I cannot review what they are doing. And I rely on their expertise and all the stakeholders who did the review. So ang magawa ko lang, which I do very well, admittedly, is magpukpuk talaga ng tao to drive a person to do what they are supposed to do. Started during the time of former DepEd Secretary Lilin Briones under the Duterte administration. The review was an extensive and painstaking process that demanded the collaboration of education stakeholders. The review.
Alright. Ayan, subaybayan po natin ang ating panayam.
Hello.
Kay
review and revisions fulfilled the Department of Education's pledge to evaluate the K-12 program following its initial implementation. The curriculum's component covering senior high school program is currently being reviewed. Among the revisions in the K-10 program include reducing the number of competencies. DepEd will give greater emphasis on the development of foundational skills such as literacy, numeracy, and social, economic, emotional skills to our kinder to grade 3 learners. The formation of our learners' values and development of their characters will be intensified in adherence to Republic Act 11476 or the GMRC and Values Education Act of 2020. The curriculum also features clearer articulation of the 21st century skills. This next feature holds a very special place in my heart. The new K-10 curriculum will integrate peace competencies, highlighting the promotion of nonviolent actions and the development of conflict resolution skills in our learners. For after all, there is security if there is peace. This curriculum will be integral to DepEd's Matatag Agenda, unveiled in January this year. DepEd's track remains to be fundamentally illuminated by the wisdom of our slogan, Matatag, Bansang Makabata, Batang Makabansa, meaning DepEd's programs and reforms are intentionally tailored to produce competent, job-ready, active, responsible, and patriotic citizens. I want to thank Secretary Liling Briones for her bold action and leadership. Binuksan ni Sec. Liling ang daan ng pagbabago na tinatahak natin ngayon para sa ating mga mag-aaral. Pursuing these reforms has been marked by foresight and demonstrated DepEd's desire to change the learning landscape of the Philippines for the sake of the future of our learners. Let me emphasize that the new curriculum is a labor of love between the Department of Education and international and local academics, the private sector, government agencies, and education stakeholders. It is designed to help improve the learning outcomes of our children and help them succeed in life. We are optimistic that this will provide our children with a meaningful learning experience that will boost their intelligence, improve their knowledge, enhance their skills and talents, and prepare them to become well-rounded, mature individuals. Allow me please to elaborate and walk you through the Matatag curriculum, which is now at the heart of the Department of Education. MA stands for Makabagong Curriculum na Napapanahon. The knowledge that we are offering our learners should be relevant, and the skills being developed are applicable and responsive to the demands of a world that constantly evolves. But while doing this, our Matatag curriculum will reintroduce the basic foundation of education to our learners, the literacy and numeracy competencies. The Matatag curriculum will ensure that in our schools, learners will master their literacy and numeracy skills. But we also hope that in their homes, our young learners will get additional coaching and teaching from the adult members of the household. We encourage families to revive the culture of coaching at home to complement our school-based efforts. TA stands for Talino na Mula sa Isip at Puso. It is important that our learners are mentally prepared to face the challenges of the world, and equally important, that they are also emotionally ready to navigate its complexities. We shall promote a balance between intelligence of the mind and maturity of the heart. Our progressive and holistic approach to education fosters creativity, critical thinking, problem solving, collaboration, adaptability, and digital and media literacy. These are essential skills needed to thrive and succeed in a contemporary society. However, we understand that genuine and lasting wisdom is a matter of the heart. We shall cultivate in the hearts of our learners the values necessary for developing their characters so that they become responsible, compassionate, and better individuals. Stop! taas stands for tapang na humarap sa anuman ang hamon sa buhay. We will harness our deep sense of identity as Filipinos in facing uncertainties and adversities as a nation. From this streams our courage and strength, resilience and readiness to unite with other Filipinos to take on any challenges that demand collective actions. Additionally, from this, we hope to witness our learners grow into patriotic citizens. G stands for Galing ng Pilipino, Nangingibabaw sa Mundo. We aim to produce learners who are ready and equipped with the necessary knowledge and skills needed for them to shine on the competitive world stage. The Filipino diaspora is characterized by various realities, but ultimately, Filipinos would always find a way not only to fit in, but also to claim the spotlight of excellence, inspiring national pride. Meanwhile, the Matatag curriculum will be brought to all Filipino learners. It will serve as the core curriculum for all learners, catered to by various inclusion programs such as the Indigenous Peoples Education Program, the Madrasa Education Program, Special Needs Education, and the Alternative Learning System. Today, we officially introduce the Matatag curriculum to you. It is a significant leap towards a better, more promising future for our learners. It offers a glowing promise in our campaign to improve the country's basic education as it brings to life our dreams and aspirations for our learners and our country. But it demands the extraordinary dedication, commitment, support, and resolve of our education stakeholders. I call on all teachers and all school officials across the country to ensure the efficient and effective implementation of the program. Let the Matatag curriculum become a testament to our faith, love, hard work, and hope for our children's future. Together, let us embrace this transformative change for our children, for their future. Let me just thank the curriculum and teaching strand of the Department of Education for the sleepless nights. For the sleepless nights, the hard work, and all the stress that we caused.
All right, thank you so much. Ayan kay BP Sara Duterte na magaling. Magaling siya mamukok daw ng ulo. Ayan sa mga tiwali. At maraming salamat sa inyong lahat. And don't forget to subscribe this channel, Rob Trip. And see you again sa ating next reaction video, and God bless us all and peace out.